But the Quran says, so with the Prophet, of course, the Quran. Follow Allah or family? So do you follow them then? Allah said to follow them. Allah said clearly, as in Arabic, السابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين تبعوهم. هم is what? Referring to مهاجرون. تبعوهم. إحسان. So what is, if you follow them in goodness, رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه وأعد لهم جنات تجري تحتها الأنهار. So this مهاجر أنصار, Allah prepared for them paradise. خالدين فيها. Okay? My point is Allah said الذين تبعوهم, follow them. Following whom مهاجر أنصار. So now, do you follow them or not? Allah said follow them.
We follow them through the path of Prophet Shamsi.
So the family in Ahl Bayt's book tells you to follow Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman and the rest of the Muhajirun? No. So how if the Prophet will follow them?
I don't know where you're coming from.
Yeah, clear, Akhi. What is
the
market?
Muhammad. The way I see it is obviously if the Prophet is giving his word to his family are going to receive it firsthand. So if
but we have Quran.
Yeah, but when he says I am from Ali and Ali is from me, or I am from Hussein and Hussein is from me, it's obviously he's giving his wilaya to them.
No, that's understandable because it's between, if we go to wilaya and al-walaya, okay, that's between wilaya and al-walaya, okay? Before we go to that, first let's establish the Quran, you know, because you as a Shi'i, probably you're going to quote me Shi'i passages.
No,
you're going to quote me? Quran, so where in the Quran is for Ahl Bayt? So you quote Shia sources.
When the Quran say follow
Muhajir Ansar, he says Muhajir Ansar.
I'm Jahil, you are Alim.
No, I'm not Alim, by the way. I'm your brother Shamsi. All of us, we learn, you know. But my point here is, what I said, look, Muhammad, I said clearly, I came from a Sufi background. And a Sufiya is very similar to Shi'ism, you see. When a brother gave me the da'wah, back in those days, I was not even practicing. I was a Jahil, proper Jahil, yeah. When he gave me da'wah about Tawheed and the way of the Sahaba, I said, this is my deen. I didn't say to him, I'm Jahil, because what is being mentioned, that is the foundation. You don't have to be a scholar to understand the foundation. So the foundation is clear in the Quran. Allah praises Sahaba more than Ahl Bayt in the Quran. Do you know that?
Well, how though? If they come from the Prophet himself?
No, I'm going to give you the verses. Allah praises Sahaba in the Quran more than Ahl Bayt. Allah said, السابقون الأول مهاجر أنصار. Another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the مهاجر أنصار. Okay? And Allah said, Allah has forgiven them and Allah has pleased with them. And there's many verses Allah praising Muhajir and Ansar. Many verses. Can you name me one verse Allah praising Ahl Bayt, which Shia believe in? Not Ahl Bayt, which the Quran speak about, general one. No, the Shia, they believe in Ahl Bayt, which is Ibn Ashr Imam, Al-Prophet, yeah? Can you show me in the Quran where, I'm not saying good names, yeah? In general, because in the Quran I say Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, but it's Muhajir Ansar. Where in the Quran praises Ahl Bayt? It does. Yeah, but not according to Shia's belief. According to Ahl Sunnah's belief. In the Quran says, which Shia always quote the verse, but they quote half of the verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَرْنَ فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ وَلَا تَبَرُّجْنَ تَبَرُّجَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ الْأُولَى وَأَقِمْنَا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتِينَا الزَّكَاةَ وَأَطِعْنَا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ يُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمْ الرِّجْزَ أَهْلِ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. This verse, Allah translates for the brothers here. This verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanding the wives of the Prophet to sit at home and they should not display themselves the way of the pre-Islamic days, yeah? And two, that Allah said Allah only wants to purify you or Ahl Bayt, yeah? From the Quran, Ahl Bayt are the wives. The proof for that is Surah Hud, 7:3 verse, yeah? Allah said that Allah speaking about the angels, speaking to the wife of Ibrahim. قالوا أتعجبين من أمر الله رحمة الله وبركاته عليكم أهل البيت. So they were addressing the wife of Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام, and they addressed the wife with أهل البيت. Another one, which is موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in Surah Al-Qasas, وسار بأهله, he traveled with his family and that was his wife. Yeah. Now Ahl Sunnah, we believe Hassan, Hussein, Fatima, they are Ahl Bayt, Ali. Yeah. How do we believe that? Not from the Quran. We believe that based upon the Sunnah. The Sunnah, because the Quran already included the wives, so the Sunnah was to include Ali, Hassan, Hussein, and Fatima. So he got them and he got the kisa, hadith kisa, yeah? The garment or the rida, and he covered them and he said, Innama yuridu Allah. So Prophet is not explaining the verse, he's including, utilizing the verse to include his brother-in-law, his cousin, his daughter, and his grandsons, yeah? Because the verse already includes the wives. That's why when his wife, Umm Salama, she said, what about us? She said, Anti ala khair. Meaning that you're up on khair. I mentioned you with the wives, clearly. So my point here is, if the Quran, it goes in line with Ahl Sunnah's belief, and doesn't go in line with the Shia's belief.
Hitler, no, but if Hitler was alive,
I'm telling you again, show me according to Quran verses for Ahl Bayt that you believe in. From the Quran.
The Prophet himself, which we follow.
So before we go to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Quran, Muhammad. From the Quran, what are you talking about? No. Brother, I called wife Shia scholars, yeah, from Holland Park. They have Husseiniyya, I called him. And I asked him the question. He said, yeah, there is. Innama yuridu Allah. I said, sorry, that is not the whole verse. The whole verse, وَقَنَّ فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ بُيُوتِكُنَّ, yeah. You misquote the verse. Anyway, there's none. There's a hadith, but before we go to hadith, because in the hadith Sahih Bukhari, Prophet said, Prophet in Bukhari, as Abdullah ibn Umar said, Ali ibn Abi Talib said, in Sahih Bukhari, anyone that favored me over Abu Bakr and Umar, I should lash him. Yeah?
Sorry?
Ali ibn Abi Talib. Would you accept that? From Sahih Bukhari, from our
book.
You accept it, yeah?
Not your book, it's our book.
Khalas, so you accept Sahih Bukhari. So Sahih Bukhari, Ali ibn Abi Talib, yeah, praised Abu Bakr and Umar. In Sahih Bukhari, and Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, every gate should be closed except the gate of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. In Sahih Bukhari, when a woman came to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, she said, O Messenger of Allah, if I come back the next year and you're not here, what should I do? He said, go to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. What does that mean? That if I die, if you die and I come back to us, he didn't say go to Ali, he said go to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Do you understand that? And what I want to mention to you, the Muhajirun and the Ansar that Allah has praised in the Quran and Allah promised them paradise, they agreed that Abu Bakr is the Khalifa after Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And they agreed that they should follow Abu Bakr as-Siddiq.
They agreed, but the Prophet agreed that Ali should take the Khalifa.
But Allah told us to follow them. If they agreed, we should agree with them as well.
But the Prophet is the message of Allah. So Allah says to the messenger, give that message.
Where? Is it in the Quran?
No.
To follow Ahl Bayt. In the Quran, follow Sahaba, Bakhi. What I'm saying,
but
Muhammad.
You are taking hadiths. Which I'm also taking hadiths.
No, I'm taking the first.
Yeah,
السابقون الأولون. Yeah. This is the first, brother. Follow them. So what I'm saying, if the Muhajirin and Ansar, who Allah praised and told us to follow them, yeah? They agreed Abu Bakr is a Khalifa and they were happy that Abu Bakr is the best of the Ummah. Now, Allah is not going to be pleased and told us to follow people who are and yet we don't follow them. So either you're gonna follow them or not. Are you gonna follow them?
Follow them in what way?
In their deen.
Of course we all the same deen, exactly the same.
So deen. From the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they believe that from the belief they had from the aqeedah that Abu Bakr is the best man.
Yeah.
Do you accept that? It's better than Ali ibn Abi Talib.
No.
So you don't follow them then?
I do follow them. It's exactly the same deen.
Muhammad, if Allah said to follow them, Allah doesn't say to follow them like they were walking the street, you follow them walking the street. No, yeah. Doesn't mean that. Follow them in their beliefs, in their methodology. In their beliefs and methodology.
So you think the Prophet would not give his same beliefs and iman to his family?
No, my point here is that if you go to the hadith, okay, you're gonna quote some hadith. Like, can you quote me a hadith that says Ali bin Abu Bakr and Umar? Quote me a hadith.
I'm not saying anyone's better than anyone.
No, but this hadith in Bukhari, Abu Bakr is better.
No, but if he's going to say, the Prophet can say, I am from Ali and Ali is from me, or I am from Hussein and Hussein is from me.
They're families, so it's understandable.
So he's saying he's giving his wilayah to somebody, his family, but because Ali was too young.
Wilayah mean khilafah.
Khilafah as in like the leadership.
Yeah, so he gave leadership to?
To Ali.
Okay, you said you follow Sahih Bukhari, yeah?
Yeah.
In Sahih Bukhari, Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib came to Ali ibn Abi Talib. He said, yeah, Ali, I know when the cousins or the children of Abdul Muttalib, they are about to die. So go ask for cinema about the Khilafah. And that was after Qadir Khumr. After, not before, after. Ali ibn Abi Talib said, I'm not going to go to ask him. Because if I do go ask him, and he said, it does not belong to us. And if I go ask him, and he said, something goes, yeah? He said, I'm not going to ask him, okay? So clearly Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda, he never understood from the hadith of Ghadir Khum that the Khilafah belongs to him. Because he could have said to Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib, after he could have said to him, Ya Abbas, don't you remember? Ghadir Khum already said I'm Khalifa. But what did he say? He said, no, I'm not going to go ask him. Because if he said it's not belong to us, then, okay? So my point here is, in Bukhari we have a hadith clear from narrators and historians. So what? But my point here is, look, brother, the Quran, stick to the Quran. The Quran says for the Muhajir and the Ansar. The Muhajir and the Ansar, the Shia, do not follow them. You claim to be Shia, but you, like I said, like a Christian, say I'm a Christian, but I don't believe Jesus is the Son of God or God. That's not Christianity, okay? Except the Christian Protestant time. You don't believe in the Prophet. So Shiism is not in the Quran. Likewise, Sunnism is not in the Quran. But the belief of Ahl Sunnah is in the Quran. As for the belief of Shia, is not in the Quran. Shia, they believe, like I said, they say the Madad Ali. They call upon Ali. They say it's permissible to pray to Allah through Ali.
As like, he's a special person.
Yeah, special person.
So we should say, like, dua to this person. Like,
yeah, make dua to him to ask Allah. Yeah, you believe that?
For him?
Yeah.
No, you can just go straight to Allah.
Yeah, Shia believe that. Yeah. And you against them?
No, I'm not against
Shia. They're going to refute you, Baba. They're going to. No, you better than them. Hayallah, al-Iraq, mashallah.
Well, yeah, basically. We can speak to Allah directly, of course, and make dua to Him.
Yeah.
But we can also say, like, through the special person.
No, that's a shirk.
We're not asking that person, we're not asking Ali.
You're asking him to ask Allah.
Not to ask Allah, to say, because He's special to you, please accept our dua through Him.
Yeah, because of His status. Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay, that's the shirk of Quraysh. And the shirk of the Christians when they used to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of Jesus. Allah called them kuffar. We pray to Allah directly. Let's see the Quran if the Quran goes in line with you. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أُدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ And your Lord said, call upon me, and I will respond to your call. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ So again, directly, عقيدة of Ahl Sunnah. Another verse, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ Again, directly. In the Quran, Allah always command us to call upon Allah directly. He never said go to call Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, except one verse that Shia use, which is إِذَا جَاءُوكَ The meaning of it. If they come to you, the Madmun ayah, if they come to you seeking forgiveness from you, لَوَجَدُ اللَّهَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا الآخر. But this ayah is not either, it's إِذْ جَاءُوكَ. Yeah? Id in the Lugha, it speaks about the past, firstly. Secondly, the context of this verse speaks about the Munafiqun. Allah said, if they repent, come to you and ask you for forgiveness, to ask for Allah, to ask Allah, and Prophet was alive, coming to him. But Allah never told us to go to Prophet and Allah said, and even I'll give you some fa'idah, my brothers and sisters, yeah? What is fa'idah? Every time Allah said, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَنْفَالِ قُلْ يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْمَحِيدِ قُلْ Every time they ask you about something, say, except وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي He didn't say قُلْ He said فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ The ulama said, look to this nukta. Nukta doesn't mean joke, nukta mean fa'ida. Yeah? He said, look to this fa'ida. Allah doesn't want to make no one between Him and His servants, even the best man that walked upon the earth, Mustafa alayhi salatu wasalam. He didn't even say قُلْ No, I'm near. So call upon Allah. So that's the belief Ahl Sunnah Jama'ah.
Well, I do as well.
Yeah, you know Shia, brother, you're Sunni. I don't
not
know
Sunni,
you.
It's the same Aqidah, bro.
Shia, don't believe that, brother. Ask a brother, yeah, Shia, I don't believe that, bro.
But you got the wrong idea about Shia.
No, I study their books, like Mufid, I study Usul Kafi, I study, akhi. I'm not speaking about from my head. I study, you know, that you pray to Ali, not you. That's a Shia's belief. So you believe is more inclined toward Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. So you are with us, Alhamdulillah. And this is the belief, you know.
Bro, it's the same deen.
No, brother,
no, it's
Shia
not
is
the same.
Deen,
it's other deen. Different.
Wallahi, akhi, wallahi, it's not my brother Muhammad. And may Allah bless you, because you can see. But what I'm saying, akhi Muhammad, look, the Quran is clear. So the Quran says for the Muhajir Ansar. Quran says call upon Allah alone. You know, there's other things which Shia believes. For example, even the Khilafah. The Khilafah now, they say Ali should be the Khalifa. Historically speaking, it was Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Who was happy with it? Al-Muhajir and the Ansar, who Allah told us to follow them. So I followed them in accepting Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Likewise, the hadith of al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam wa ala alihi wa sahbihi, he said, what do they call it? Went to the woman, if I'm not alive next year, go to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, indicating, and Ali ibn Abi Talib, what he said, even the Shia sources, Ali ibn Abi Talib said, if we were happy for Abu Bakr to lead us in a prayer, and we trust him in a prayer, how can we not trust him in the deen to be Khalifa? You see?
It's because he was older. That's why.
Who was older?
Abu Bakr was older.
What do you mean, he was older?
So he took the leadership because he was older in age. So they didn't trust Ali to take the leadership because he was younger. A lot younger than
that's not correct. It's not about older or younger. Maybe that can play a role, but it's about Prophet pointing him.
Who points him?
Prophet he said to the woman, if I die and you come back, now who's giving the fatwa? Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Yes. Who's teaching? And Nabi Alayhi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The woman is asking, if I do come back next year, who shall I go back to?
Yeah.
In a deen, now knowledge. Knowledge you go back to, Prophet should told her to go back to who's more knowledgeable. He told her to go back to Abu Bakr. Sahih Bukhari. And my point here is, that's why I always advise the Shia, those who are sincere, yeah? I said, look, read the Quran. Reflect upon the Quran, by Allah you become Sunni. When I read the Quran, I left Sufism. I hope I read the book Tawheed first. Because but when I start reading the Quran, you know, reading the Quran clearly. Abudullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa qala rabbukum. Clearly Tawheed. Following the Sahaba. Praising the Sahaba. Akhi, in Usul al-Kafi, said the majority of the Sahaba become kuffar except three. Al-Maqdad, Salman al-Farisi, Abu Dhar. That go and guess the book of Allah, who said the Muhajir Ansar, Allah speaks of them. And go and guess the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about the bay'ah of Radwan. Which over thousands. Over thousands, yeah? That it goes and guess it. So the Shia sources go and guess the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sources that goes in line with the Quran, Salafi sources, Sunni sources, alhamdulillah. And do research, study about Shiism, and look, what is it? Because you are telling me they don't believe that. They do believe that. That is their sources, these are their books, you know?
Maybe, yeah, but I don't believe that.
Alhamdulillah, Ahsan.
What I believe in is that you should respect them. Family
without any doubt
and remember them,
so and love them and yes. Defend them.
So when I go to like ziyarah, yeah, or like stuff like that,
ziyarah to where?
To Karbala.
Who died in Karbala?
Hussein and Abbas.
Hussein was buried in Egypt.
It was the battle of Karbala when he was killed in Karbala.
Yeah,
in Karbala.
You know,
no
what?
One knows.
There's two graves for Hussein, you know that, isn't it? There's one in Karbala,
yeah,
and there's one in Egypt. No, you know, there's even historians, as some ulama mentioned, no one really knows where Hussein is buried. Except some people, some ulama say he was in Medina.
So what's your opinion on Karbala?
But Karbala, those who killed Ali, they're evil. May Allah curse them.
Hussein.
Allah. May Allah curse them. And they were oppressors. And they were shayateen.
So who are they?
It's not Muawiyah, by the way, and he's not Yazid. Doesn't mean I'm supporting Yazid, yeah? But we speak of justice. It was not Yazid. Yazid never commanded for Hussein to be killed. The proof of that Yazid and Arda, rather the Shia sources mention Shia betrayed him. The Shia. And he's in the book of your sources.
Yeah, the Kufa.
And
Kufa.
Ali ibn Abi Talib cursed the Shia. The Shia, yeah? His followers. Al Hassan, same thing. Are you aware of that, yeah?
No.
Yeah,
you have to read it.
Nahj al-Balagha. Many sources, yeah? Likewise, Hussein. Likewise, Abu Abdullah Ja'far al-Sadiq. Yeah, radiallahu anhu wa ardahum. So, those who betrayed him and killed him, I believe the Shia, they killed him. That's why, why Shia hate themselves? Why they hate themselves? In Day of Karbala, Day of Hussein. Why? This came from people who called Tawwabun. After the death of Hussein, they were Shia called Tawwabun. They used to lash themselves because they believed they betrayed Ali. That's why he was murdered. They were the reasons.
No, that's not the reason why I do it or why I
was. So you beat yourself?
I don't beat myself.
But you cut yourself?
On your chest.
Yeah, why are you tapping your chest?
Because when Hussein alayhi salam was killed, the leader of the army asked the army to step on his chest with the horses.
Prove that.
It's all in the book.
Yeah, but books history, there's a lot of stories which are not true.
Yeah, but it's all hadiths passed down generations. We don't
no, that's not books of history. No, books of history is not like that. Hadith is different. Books of hadith. Books of history, like if you read Abu Ja'far Muhammad Jir Tabari, his kitab, Tariq al-Muluk wal-Umam, okay? He mentioned that in the introduction that I'm just narrating. What is a tariq? A tariq is al-makan wal-zaman wal-insan. And al-hayawan kadalik, yeah? So al-makan was. So they're narrating what happened, you know? That's why, as al-Qahtani said, let khud al-ilma min. I forget, but he said, don't take knowledge from the books of history. Because history, anything has been said. For example, they said Muawiyah used to curse Ali. That's not true. That's in the book of history. And there's no chain of narration. Rather, some chain of narrators, some narrators are liars. They're not to be liars. So what I'm saying, even we know they oppress Ali, but we should not start making up things about them. Now, do you do that when Prophet's death? Do you hit yourself? Ali was killed. Why did you hit yourself like that? But he was killed as well.
Yeah, but he's praying. He was praying.
Not to cry for him and hit yourself?
No, because it's a peaceful death. He died during...
He was killed. That's not peaceful.
But he was praying, so of course it's peaceful death.
But he was stabbed, bro. I mean, no one believes that. Yeah, but that is not a peaceful death. Peaceful death...
Of course, but it's instant of...
Look, it's even in this term, peaceful death, as a Muslims, even dying in the war, that's a peaceful death too.
Yeah.
We don't have this peaceful death, you have to die in a bed, because you can't die in your bed and you're a kafir ta'ut. And that's not peaceful death, you know, just to make that clear. Peaceful death doesn't mean that. But what I'm saying, he died and he was killed. Hussein was killed, and both of them were oppressed and killed, but you cry for Hussein, but you don't cry for Ali ibn Abi Talib. Do you know why? I'll tell you why. The only man that was married to the Persians woman, it was Hussein. And did you know Shi'ism, if you look back to it, yeah? Why is a lot of Shia hate Umar al-Khattab? Umar al-Khattab is one of the people that conquered and defeated the army of the Persians. So some hypocrites, they couldn't defeat Islam in a war. They pretend to be Muslims and they came in. One of them, Abdullah ibn Saba. Abdullah ibn Saba, some Shia scholars shut in the gate, say he didn't exist. But some Shia scholars do affirm him that he didn't exist. And he had the same mentality of Musa and Harun. Or Yusha, you give the Khilafah to him. So that's why there's very similarity, there's a lot of similarities between Judaism and Shi'ism. You understand? So look what I would say to you, Akhi, look, Muhammad, yeah? My point here is, what you're saying, Shia do not believe what you're saying. That you call God alone. No, you have to go through Ali. That's what they believe. Okay?
You don't have to.
No, they have to.
You don't have to.
Yeah, they say this. It's better.
Qasim al Jinn wal Nar.
They don't say, Ya Hussein?
Yeah.
Why? What is Ya Hussein in Arabic? It's Arabic? ما معنى يا حسين في اللغة؟
Ya Abi is a calling
of
someone. Ya حرف نداء. Yeah. If my father is not here, and I said, oh my father, either I'm just crazy, or I believe my father is going to hear me. Because Ya حرف نداء, you call upon your father. So Ya Hussein, what is the intent behind it? Why do you say Ya Hussein?
What the Quran says, don't think that the Shahad, the people who died, Shaheed, are dead but alive with Allah.
Allah didn't say yarziqoon. Allah said yurziqoon. They've been provided. No, they provide for people.
No.
Yeah, but they cannot hear us.
I don't agree with that.
But they cannot hear us. My point.
I don't say Ya Hussein, do this for me. I say Ya Allah, do this for me.
No, when the Shia say Ya Hussein, what do they say?
It's calling of Hussein, not to make dua.
But where is it for?
Just to call him.
Well, he can't hear them. Why is he calling them? He's majnoon. Imagine I said to you, Ya Hussein. Brother, anyone Hussein? No Hussein. Shamsi, why is he Hussein? Are you okay? Ya Hussein. Either I'm just saying because I'm majnoon, or there is qasd. You know, after qasd. There is something that the intent behind calling open Hussein. And you hear Shia. You don't hear Shia say, Al-Madad Ya Ali? Al-Madad Ya Ali. Hadi ma'roof, Ali. In Iraq. Al-Madad Ya Ali. No, not you, Shia. أخي لا تدوم هذا المدد مين؟ That's a good point. But let me make you hear Shia say it in the phones. You know, I'll show you. هذا مرة كافر مرة هندو مرة بودي هذا مخلط هذا. He doesn't know if he's Bodhi, if he's Hindu, he's a Christian, he's everything. He's more confused than confused.com.
So what are you today?
He said Buddha is better than Prophet ﷺ, smarter. Astaghfirullah. This is kufr. أنت كافر بالله واليوم الآخر. This is no joke.
Worse than this kafir.
مرة إذا دعاه. No one save you from the hardship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you call upon a human being to save you in a hardship who is not there, that doesn't make any sense. That's a shirk billah. And that's what the Arab pagans used to do. Rather, the Arab pagans, they never used to do it in a time of hardship. In a time of hardship, they used to make dua sincerely to Allah. When Allah saves them, they go back to shirk. SubhanAllah. In our time, the people who commit shirk, from a Shia and a Sufi and other than them, they make shirk in a time of ease and a time of hardship. You understand? So they do, akhi. No, it's ma'roof, ya akhi, Muhammad. Tell you, ayy, kawkab anta? Kawkab Zuhara?
I don't do that. All I'm here to say that we're all Muslims and it's not issue.
Yeah, no, there is issues, brother. You can't deny it. I mean, there is a Shia issues, there is between the Sufi issues. But what we say, Muhammad, look, study. But, this guy, no one listened to you. You said Buddha, Peter Prophet, Prophet shoes better than anyone else. Allahu Akbar. Prophet, the best man upon the earth. Prophet, he came with the legislation that we have the best politicians around the world studying the best universities. They cannot resolve the problem. But where is the solution? Is what Muhammad ibn Mustafa ibn Abdullah alayhi salam came with.
Brother, you had it, it's nothing.
That's why, you know, subhanAllah. So you're saying that, listen what you're saying. You, Dubai, is that, let me ask, is there war in Dubai?
No.
Is there war in Abu Dhabi?
No, of course.
Is there war in Algeria?
No, wait. America
is a big shaitan, tahoot. No. Will America goes destroy countries? America destroy countries. You're from Afghanistan, correct? Yeah. Who destroy your country, man?
No.
America came, bombed and killed a woman when there was a wedding. They bombed a wedding, man died, and the woman she was getting married, they killed her and the child. And you're talking about Afghanistan.
No, Afghanistan.
The real man, you're a fake Afghani, man. You're a fake Afghani. You're not Afghani, you're a fake Afghani. Afghani brothers here, mashallah. Afghani is a real man, man. Afghani woman, strong woman too.
He's fake, yes, man.
Wallahi, you're a real man. You're a fake one. You made it. He's Al-Shabaab, baby. Even Russia to be Muslim.
Muslim kill Muslim thousand, this Al-Shabaab.
Christian call it Christians. What do you think? Christian killing Christians. World War II, how many people died?
Sorry?
World War II, how many people died?
50 million.
In the history, no one caused that problem. In history, no one. In the past or the future. I mean, the future of Alam.
No, brother, they never said you fight the cause of Allah. They said for Allah.
What's your name again? Mahfour, listen. You know, no, listen. Mahfour. When the people went to America, when the European went to America, and kill the Native Americans, they were doing it in the name of Christianity. Mm. When Europeans came to Africa and they enslaved the black people, it was in the name of Christianity. Christopher Columbus, it was a Catholic Christian who killed the Native Americans, Native Canadians, and Native Australians, and Native Afghans.
In the name of Christianity.
In the name of Christianity. So no one killed people like the Christians.
If they kill the name of Christian, they are tourists.
Do you leave this one? France.
Yeah, no, I'm Algerian friend. Algeria, you know, I'll tell you about history. You have to learn about history. Listen, did you know that when the French and Britain and America were celebrating their victory over Hitler in 1948, it was the same year when the French were killing and raping and destroying Algeria. Look at the hypocrisy. So in one way, we want to save the Jewish people. No, listen. In one side, they care about the Jewish people, but on the other side, American and Britain, they never said to a French, hold a minute, you hypocrite. You come in to save Jewish people, but you're in the country of Algeria, killing, destroying the people. They never said that. You see, so Eva, no. Islam, Algeria is a good country, alhamdulillah. The country that has a war, there is no country has a war except America was there.
No more.
Afghanistan, Iraq. Saddam was good. May Allah have mercy upon Saddam.
No, wait, listen.
Did you know, before America came to Iraq, Iraq was very civilized. Iraq, they were very high in education. Iraqis, there were many doctors, many scientists. So, you know, America came, the dream of America destroyed Iraq.
صحبه وتابع لهديه مغرد الحمام وسبح الأنام.